When we met, I immediately put you in a specific box. I put you in the friend zone. And I had no intentions of changing that. But you very much did. And I put you through the ringer. I made you jump through all sorts of hoops. But you remained so confident and so sure that we were meant to be something more. And as much as it pains me to admit when I'm wrong, I was wrong about you.
And Lauren, thank you so very much for agreeing to marry David. And by that, I meant not just that I was very happy for David, but I was also really happy for myself. You are a caring, wise, talented, beautiful person, and I couldn't have asked for a better daughter-in-law.
I go crazy sometimes. Can you leave it? Yeah, I swear I'm fine, that I'm all right, but I'm barely breathing. Thought I could find my way back home, but I get lost alone.
I am so proud of you and so happy for you. You have been and continue to be a wonderful son, and you have become a marvelous young man. You are kind and funny and compassionate and generous, and I love you.
Lauren, I know I speak for the whole family when I say how lucky we feel to be counting you as our newest member. I also know I speak for the whole family when I say how grateful we are to you just for looking after this guy. Truly, who knows where he would be without you. But I know for sure he would not be in a place this beautiful on this day if you were not here. So thank you. There are a lot of small reasons I look up to you, David. You've always been the cool older brother. You've always carried yourself with great confidence. You've always been a great athlete. You even always had great style, but it was always better than me, so you're good there. More recently, you've got this whole new suburban dad vibe going. You know, it's everything's yard projects and grilling and pool maintenance. There are larger ways I look up to you too, though. Ever since I can remember, you've had this absolutely boundless energy for life. I have always admired this so much about you. And it continues to inspire me to this day to live my life with the same energy and enthusiasm that you do.
I'm no longer wondering when I'm with you, I can finally breathe. When I'm with you, I swear to God, I swear to God, I'm who I want to be. I'm who I'm who I want to be.
More than anything, the way I most look up to my big brother is the life and partnership you and Lauren have created. Watching you two grow together over these past 100 or so years, I am so fortunate to have you two to look up to. The trust, respect, and love you two display for each other is something that is apparent to all and we can all learn from. I am so, so proud of my big brother. For the boyfriend, the fiance, and now the husband that he has become. And I thank you for setting an example for your dorky little brother.
I found a love for me. Well, darling, just dive right in and follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Well, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. 'Cause we were just kids when we fell in love. Not knowing.
Thank you for coming today to help witness and celebrate the wedding of Lauren Ann Schaefer and David Edward Kaiser.
But darling, just kiss me.
Today, on our wedding day, I vow to never stop doing the things that I believe have gotten us to where we are today as a couple. And I promise to continue to do these things in our next chapter as husband and wife. I promise to never stop dating you or traveling the world with you, exploring new places and cultures together. However, I will be in charge of our passports going forward.
Barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it, darling, you look perfect tonight.
We make each other laugh every single day. Even on our worst days, we find a way to make each other laugh when we need it the most. And I vow to never stop growing together as a couple, while also maintaining a healthy level of immaturity, always. I love you, and I like you, and I can't wait to do this life with you.
Well, some people remember the first time they met their significant other, and there's much dispute about when we first met. I do remember the first dozen times I met you. Your energy, your beauty, your laughter took a hold of me then and has never let go of the last 12 years. Your laughter has always been an important part of our relationship. In the early days, I came close to calling an ambulance because you couldn't breathe from laughing so hard. And I came to learn this was a semi-regular occurrence. Traveling has showed me that you love to try new things, to explore, and that you should always hold their passports.
Confirmed.
As your husband, I vow to you for all eternity to always support you, to always love you unconditionally, and to be faithful.
When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this. Darling, you look perfect tonight.
When on the hardest of days, which will inevitably come, on days when not even you can make yourself laugh, that I will be there to bring the good kind of tears to your eyes. This, Lauren Ann, is what I vow to you.
I now pronounce you Mr. and Mrs. David and Lauren Kaiser. Not yet.
I have faith in what I see. Now I know I have met an angel in person, and she looks perfect. I don't deserve this.
Please join me in congratulating and welcoming the newly married couple.
I get no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol, it doesn't move me at all. So tell me, why should it be true that I get a kick out of you?
There were many times growing up when the last thing I wanted to do was hang out with my little sister. With time, I think we both learned that a sister offers you the chance at a lifelong friendship that nobody else can quite understand. And for us, that bond has grown quite stronger within the last several years.
I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to me you obviously don't adore me. I get no kick in a plane, flying too high with some gal in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Yet I get a
out of you. I hope today is the day that you love each other the least. I hope you grow and evolve both as individuals and as a couple. My wish for you is that in 5, 10, 25, and 50 years from now, you have a deeper, richer, and fuller love than you have today.
I could wish these two luck in their future together, but I don't think luck has much to do with the lives that they've made for themselves. They both have this amazing sense of adventure and this just curiosity for life that is really inspiring. You both found your perfect person, and you're surrounded by people that love you and wish only the best for you.
I get a kick every time I see you standing there before me. I get a kick, though it's clear to me you obviously do not adore me. I get no kick in a plane, flying too high with some gal in the sky is my idea of nothing to do. Yet I get a kick, yes, I get a kick, yes, I get a kick.